Yeah, definitely. Especially, it's a major decision. It could be life-changing, and it has to do not just with work opportunity, but ministry. I mean, is it my assignment? Because, you know, there are many things that I discovered, okay, that are good, that are godly, that are for God, but may not be your assignment. There have been missteps also along the way where, uy, that's a call from God. And then you walk there and then suddenly a door slams at you because it's not for you. Okay, you get hurt in the process, but you learn a lesson. You learn a lesson to sharpen your hearing, your spiritual hearing, okay? Sharpen your faith, just sharpen your spiritual instincts, you know? This is from God, this is not from God. You know, there have been missteps also. Until, yun nga, I inquire, you pray, there's a word, people get advice, godly counsel is important also. Open doors, smooth anointing, and then find yourself in that situation. And sometimes when you're in the situation, there's still giants that you face, like Joshua in Jericho, diba? It was difficult for them to enter Jericho, but once they're there, they also have to still continue fighting the giants. Parang ganun pa rin, no? So just like David, you who daily inquires of God, Abraham daily inquired of God, Jesus daily inquired of God, so that you know that what you're gonna do is as God directs you. So you don't make missteps, you don't make a mistake. Other things that the Lord can give you a vision about, okay? So you have to learn how to determine whether that vision is for tomorrow or for next year or for 10 years from now. That's why the daily inquiring of God is important. Because the problem, I think, with visions or even the visionaries, there's nothing wrong with the vision, it's the visionary, the one who receives it, is they could make a mistake of jumping it. It's for 10 years pa pala. Okay? Because God orders things in steps. You know? That's why we were taught by Paul about the soldier who disciplines himself, the farmer, diba, who sows and does these things before he harvests. Well, soldier, athlete, and the farmer, diba? May process. Not everything happens overnight. So, I'm also of the belief that the bigger the vision, the deeper the foundation also. Like, the taller the building, the deeper the foundation, diba? So before you even show a semblance of a building or street or something, you have to dig deep first. And normally the Lord does that to us first in our souls, in our way of thinking, in the way we do things. He cleanses us, He purifies us. We sanctify ourselves before we can even do anything. Actually, because if you read the Word regularly and you're familiar, diba? Sometimes a text message to God, diba? And a text response, you'll already understand. Just like parents, for example, diba? A child, if you're with your mom every day, you know her voice, you know her expressions, diba isang nod lang ng head or wink ng eye or alam mo na eh. Even without a word, diba? You already know the message that your mom is telling you. I think it's the same with our relationship with God, you know? If you're there with Him daily, you know Him, you know what works and what doesn't work with Him, diba? Yung mga palusok mo na that works or do not work. You know that Jesus said, my sheep, they know my voice, diba? So it's the same thing, okay? But sometimes God is quiet. Maybe you ask the wrong question. Right? Maybe your question is self-serving. And nakaganyan lang siya sa'yo. Diba? I'm waiting for you to ask the right question. I am privileged to be working in a ministry that our product is the Word of God and the Gospel. So even in our line of work, it is something that we study, consult, and use, okay, as our product. So whether you have time to do it at home or not, when I get to my office, I have the opportunity to do that. And our ministry, CBN, is particular also about having our weekly chapel services, our daily devotionals. So it's better than a church. We are immersed in the Word. Parang you have no choice kasi it's your product. Eh. The Word of God is our product. Oh, definitely. Actually, when I was still in ABS at the time, and I found myself hungry for the Word of God. That I read it until 3 a.m. And I would even say, God, we have to stop meeting like this because I have to work in the morning. So what did God do? He removed my work. He took me out of ABS-CBN. And ganun. So it started with a genuine hunger for God. Eh? And I think the problem as we grow older and as we get used to, you know, to the Lord's presence and His goodness to us, is sometimes we're so busog, we're no longer hungry. And that is where the danger comes. Because we do not anymore feast on the Word of God. Like I said, sometimes text message na lang, you know, with the technology pa, mga ganyan-ganyan na parang in lifestyle mo, ganun na lang din, diba? But if the Word is in you, and you've chewed on it, and you've masticated it, and it's already in you, I think it's something that that can be pulled out anytime, or the Lord brings to your recollection. The Holy Spirit will remind you of what He has taught you. So it's something that's there. So even in inquiring of God, Lord, I have to do this. Can I do this? What should I do? Diba? If there are no answers, go back to your book. Study. Research. You know, just like in any business or, diba? Or in school, diba? You research. But if it's there, it's in your computer file, and then He brings it out, this is the answer for this, then you know now, you have a guide now what to do for the day.